So you started this firm in what year?
2009.
And how much money do you manage now?
About $18 billion today.
And how many offices do you have? One here, and you have one in New York now?
Well, the office question's gotten more complicated because we have people moving all over the place. Moving all over the place. So technically, we have two primary offices here, actually, Menlo Park and San Francisco. We have a smaller office in New York that we'll be expanding, and we have another probably half dozen locations.
And how many professionals do you have looking for deals or doing deals?
Yeah, the deal team is probably, I'm going to guess, 60 people or so, probably in total.
But when people can approve a deal, do they tell you they've done it, or
yes.
How do you?
Yeah, so we run a full process. Everything gets discussed. We're verticalized, so we have these different vertical teams that basically go out and work in all these different categories. Ben and I are on each of the vertical teams, so we're in the middle of everything.
Let's suppose somebody comes in and they make a presentation, and you, the founder of the firm, like it a lot. Can you get outvoted by your colleagues or not?
So we run a non-consensus process very deliberately. So we run what we call single trigger puller. And so each general partner in our firm, and we have about 22 of those right now, each of those has an investment budget. And then that each of those general partners can make an investment decision without a vote. And we do that very deliberately because our view is a lot of the best startup ideas don't fit in existing boxes. And if you have a group, you know, kind of a committee discussion process, you'll end up talking yourself out of some of the best deals.
So if you have a committee process, you don't actually ever need a consensus. Basically, you're a trigger puller, presumably.
Yeah.
Right? And so if somebody goes to you and says, Mark, I want you to do this, and you say, I don't want to do that, can they forum shop by going to your partners and saying, well, Mark didn't like it, but you might like it. Can they do that? Or once you have one shot at it at your firm and you're done?
They can do that. There's often a fit to the specific GP. So our basic model is the GP, the general partner who's the closest to the domain, who understands the most about that market sector, should make that decision. It should be the right partner. You know, that said, sometimes one partner doesn't like it, another partner likes it, they pick it up and do it. We do talk a lot. And so every once in a while, entrepreneurs try to kind of work around us, and they try to kind of surprise us and play the game.
It's like a child with a parent if they forum shop.
Yes, exactly. So, every once in a while, but we tend to pick up when that happens.